Hey Raiders, homecoming is almost here. I know it'll be fun for everyone. Homecoming is about being excited, celebrating, and coming together as Raiders. There'll be a football, both boys and a Potter Pup game, a pep fest, tailgating, and a lot of other events throughout the week. Homecoming is also another time that we look back at the history of Roseville Area High School. So, we thought we might take a moment to look back at homecoming highlights from previous years. Next, we are going to hear from a group of students and staff, the homecoming committee, to talk about what we as a community believe about how we can celebrate so that everyone enjoys the week. Next, we are going to hear from student council about what's coming up in this next week. So, let's get started and look back at homecoming.
In the platinum band, and this time we're gonna get funky. Funky. Everybody clap your hands. Clap, 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 clap your hands. Clap, 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 clap your hands. All right, now we're gonna do the basic step to the left. Take it back now, y'all. One hop this time. Right foot, let's start.
football games on Friday night, and I danced on the dance line, and we had to have a very special dance that night. But that wasn't unusual. We had a new dance every single Friday for our home games.
Hi, one of my memories of homecoming is when we were as part of a student group, we decided to put a float in the homecoming parade, and we had used my garage, and we had a hay wagon, and at the end of the hay wagons are posts, so we made the posts the goal posts.
We graduated from East Grand Forks, and we were the Green Wave, so I remember lots of red, green, and white, and everyone having a lot of fun and participating, but certainly nothing memorable. So hopefully our students will remember their Raider Pride experience to a greater effect than I do.
But I do remember my brother's homecomings even more. They were about 10 years before mine. And they used to have big bonfires out in the parking lot that everybody came to. And then the marching band would go around and around and around and keep blowing the trumpets and all that kind of stuff. And it was really, really fun.
I went to Mankato East High School. Class of 1984, our escorts for our queen were, the escorts for the queen were picked by the staff members, and my swimming coach elected me as one of the escorts, and I really didn't want to do it, but it turned out it was a lot of fun. I felt a little like King Nerd for that weekend. It was awesome fun.
And for homecoming, we had real full floats that you pull behind cars. Well, the cheerleaders decorated the float at a gas station 2 miles away from the school. It was so big that I had to call the police and get a police escort to get it from the gas station to the stadium.
We wanted the football players to be on this float, which they didn't really cooperate with us at that point in time. So
homecoming comes along and I find myself without a boyfriend. Went to the dance with a bunch of girlfriends. Met my husband there. He asked me to dance, and 6 years later we were married.
I missed one meeting and came back to the next one and found out I was one of the football players, which I looked a little ridiculous because the other guy that was a football player in front of me was huge.
Well, Roz, I'd just like to see all our students, number one, have a great time and make some memories and have fun. And I would just like to see that great time done in a really positive fashion, participating in all of our school events, all of our school pride days, and definitely showing up at all of our activities and supporting kids who are participating. So number one, just having fun and being positive.
Hello, people of Roseville. My name is Andrew Paul.
I'm Taylor.
And we are here to talk to you about Pep Fests.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, what is school pride?
School pride is wearing your school colors and attending school functions.
Awesome. It's the best when people cheer at Pep Fest, like, go Raiders! And other cheers like that.
School song.
And exactly like that.
What is respect?
When it's like a special week, I'll wear it.
Treating everybody in a civil manner, making nobody else's day worse than it might be.
All right. Thank you.
Can you tell us how you show school pride?
I'm a cheerleader. Woohoo! They're also cheerleaders. Woohoo!
What's respect look like at a pep fest?
No cell phones.
Pep fans there, come and join. Sing along. It'll be a great time.
How do you show respect in a pep fest?
You cheer when you're supposed to cheer. You're quiet when you're supposed to be quiet. When you're just legs talking. Wear Raider gear. Like that.
And don't talk.
Don't talk, because that's disrespect. And not cool.
And not cool. So, thank you, and
go Raiders!
I believe students should show respect at a school pep fest.
Well, at a school pep fest, I believe that it is all about the students, so whoever students show respect, it's a reflection on themselves. So So for the national anthem, of course, standing up and being respectful. And the same for our school song, because that is essentially showing school pride, to stand up during the school song, no matter what event you're at. The same with respecting each other and respecting any speaker or performer that's on stage. So again, pep fests are just about school pride and respecting yourself and your friends.
Do you know what they say? Life ain't always easy.
Hi everyone, my name's Christina and I'm a senior.
Hi, my name is Ava and I'm a sophomore.
And hi, I'm Liberty, I'm also a sophomore.
Next week is homecoming week. Student Council has a lot of exciting activities planned.
On Monday, the Spirit Day is class color. Seniors wear blues, juniors wear green, sophomores wear red, freshmen wear yellow, and staff wear orange.
Tuesday is get up and go. Why get dressed in the morning when you can wear your pajamas to school?
Wednesday is Minnesota Pride Day. Wear your favorite Twins t-shirt or support your favorite college sports team.
Thursday is Twin Day. Grab a friend and wear the exact same clothes. You don't need a real twin to participate.
Friday is Raider Pride Day. Wear your favorite Raider gear to get excited for the big game.
Throughout the week, we'll have lots of exciting activities.
This week at lunch, there will be homecoming nominations, and next week will be royalty voting.
Tuesday is the pancake breakfast. Come to school early to get free pancakes.
Friday, we'll be having a pet fest. Remember that you can audition for the pet fest.
Stay tuned to the announcements to hear more about our exciting activities. Come on now.
Let's all celebrate and have a good time.